Okay, it's August 21st, 2015. And I was just gonna show you this brown spot that I talked about on an earlier video in the trees. You see, that's about 30 feet, 40 feet from the Monsanto man-made, genetically engineered with pesticide in corn-like product. And look at the trees here. This one here I'm not worried about so much, but it's on the corner here. It's like two or three trees built, intertwined together. And it's got a vine up in there, which again, if it chokes it off, it chokes it off. But well, it's third week in August, and the sunflowers have been dead for about 2 weeks, the Titan sunflowers. Actually, I don't know. That one on the corner there might be a Titan. These others might, I may have had some sunflower seeds from a different packet I had a long time ago, and I threw them out. But you look at how they're all died off up here in the garden. Except for that one there, which, again, I'm not going to say for sure because I'm not positive it was Titan. But see, I did put Titan seeds out, and look at the ones in the back there. All those back there, they're about 14 feet tall. As is that one right there in the corner. Next year, this all have a torch, those orange flowers, those orange sunflower torch mixing here with these. So, but now look at this tree here. This is the first one, main one I consider on the property. Now look at the brown spot leaves. All, it's not just one branch either. It's all the way up in the tree. This is closer to me, so I'm going to do a branch that's about face level right here. You can see the spot on it. Now, I've been here for 4 years. Haven't had no problems. None. Zero like this. This year, earlier in the year, I said something about it when I was out here looking how it's all over this tree. And then it's on this tree here. This is the one that the hummingbirds tend to go up into a lot during the summer. Again, I'll zoom into a branch that's closer to the face level right here. So you can see all the brown spot on the leaves. And it's like that throughout this tree. Now it's two trees being this close to each other. Yeah, you can see. Then this tree here has it. This tree is about 25 feet away from the last two trees. These are the lower branches that are about face height. You can say what you want and you can laugh till you fucking choke. That sky is not a natural sky anymore. It hasn't been for about 25, 30 years. Those are not clouds, unless you want to call them chem clouds, because that's what they are. That's been going on since the 1940s, actually, but they're in demand probably about 60s, mid, late 60s, after they got rid of Kennedy, the last sitting president. Now we got these, or supposedly silkworms. They got this web-like stuff all through the trees here. There's a bunch in this tree this year. I haven't seen it like this before since we've been here for 4 years. And earlier, I saw a lot of the pre-pods and such right there for... I can't see on the screen, so I'm going to have to try to zoom in the best I can and see if I can see some on there underneath the crack on it. You see those pods right there for pecans. This should be a really big year this year. And then now, like I said, look at this. Look at all the webs up there for the worms. I don't know if that's going to deter this or what now. Look at that. Plus, you know, a little bit of brown spot in this tree. And as you can see here, if you look at the dirt here, there's voles and or moles in this out here. Look at this, huh? So I let nature take care of nature. Everything out here is natural. I don't use any insecticides or pesticides other than an ivory soap, even though ivory is not the pure soap it once was, because they've been bought out like everything else. But I'm using it as more of a pure soap than that. About an eighth of a bar in a gallon container, let it start dissipating in water, and spraying that for insects. And I get the off-brand blue dishwashing liquid put in there too. Because Dawn is a name, and that's what people go by, the name. I put that in there for insects. Disease is the soap. Oh, wait, it's the soap. No, disease is baking soda and water. A tablespoon of baking soda to a gallon of water, and sometimes I make